Hi, I'm Gene Okerlund, and this is WWE Confidential. This coming Monday, WWE returns to the world's most famous arena, Madison Square Garden, the home of next year's WrestleMania, WrestleMania 20. There is no place more fitting to hold an event of this magnitude, considering MSG was also the site for the very first WrestleMania held in 1985. Later tonight, we'll take a look at the event that propelled the WWE to where it is today and see why Madison Square Garden was such a big reason. For the better part of the last century, wrestling has been a fixture at Madison Square Garden, and so has the McMahon family. Consider the fact that just 20 years ago, wrestling was divided into multiple territories with the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, currently the WWE, occupying the northeast portion of the United States. The Northeast Territory enabled the McMahons to call Madison Square Garden their home. It began with Vince's grandfather, Jess McMahon, a boxing promoter for Madison Square Garden, who in 1935 started to add wrestling to the card. Eventually, Vince's father, Vince McMahon Sr., took over the business and at one point sold out MSG 21 consecutive times. For all of his amazing work, Vince McMahon Sr. was inducted into Madison Square Garden's Hall of Fame back in 1984. When Vince McMahon Jr. took over the business from his father, he took what was a small territorial company and made it into a global phenomenon. But even now, with our television programming seen in over 100 countries, the WWE still only calls one place its home.
Madison Square Garden is universally considered the most famous sports arena in the world. Not to mention the fact that Vince's father always considered that the premier venue for wrestling. And I think everybody in the company knows how special Madison Square Garden is to Vince, and that just makes it that much more special to everyone involved with the WWE.
There's something so special about Madison Square Garden. I feel the presence of my grandfather there whenever we're there, and I know my dad does too. And I just, every show we ever do there, be it a house show or a television show, it's always very, very special to me.
Few events at the Garden or any place else in any arena, any place, can boast of the amazing success of McMahon-produced wrestling cards.
If ever there was one individual who carried the banner of Madison Square Garden, no one quite did it like my dad. He was so proud to be associated, as was his father before him, and as I am now. He would say, with his New York accent, remember one thing, the Garden will always be the Garden.
I wrestled in New York in 1961. For Vince McMahon's father. They held the old Garden, a show once a month. We sold it out 15 straight months in a row. And one time we drew the sellout's a sellout, but we drew what they said was the biggest house in the history of the Garden for any event. Joe Louis fights or political events or the circus or whatever. And they turned an estimated 10,000 people away, and they kept selling tickets. I don't know where they got them or what happened, but the people were sitting on the aisles, on the steps, and the fire department was going crazy, and the police, and it was really something.
Everybody, boxer, wrestler, or what, any kind of sporting event, when you hit Madison Square Garden, you were the cream of the crop. You couldn't go no higher than that. Madison Square Garden was the number one place. You appeared there, you knew that you had reached the top.
My actual first match in Madison Square Garden was late in 1972, and at that time Pedro Morales was the champion, but before that it was Bruno, you know, who made Madison Square Garden as a wrestling pinnacle, and then superstar Billy Graham.
I was one of the first ladies to wrestle in Madison Square Garden in 1972. It's just so much to say about Madison Square Garden. It's just wonderful. It's nothing like it.
Every moment that you can think of in history usually stem right from Madison Square Garden, where they would always come once a month. I have so many great moments from Madison Square Garden. I was one of the regulars. I would go almost every month. I was one of a faithful, if you call it. And from Jimmy Snuka diving off the cage.
Superfly perch, 15 feet high. Oh my God!
Sergeant Slaughter, you know, in a boot camp match against Pat Patterson. Hulk Hogan first night walking out and beating the Iron Sheik.
Hulk Hogan, he drops a big leg on him. He's down for the cover of the leg. 1, 2, he got him.
The WWE has given me so many great moments, and they all happened in Madison Square Garden.
Anytime you do something in Madison Square Garden, it's usually amplified because that's the Mecca. That's the, you know, this greatest arena on earth. So the Garden always brings out the best, not only in the performers, but the audience as well.
New York, I love you, baby!
The magic of Madison Square Garden combined with the aura of WWE has always been a perfect blend. The magic that evolves in the world's greatest arena is unparalleled to anything else that you want to experience.
When Rocky Maivia came out in the Garden, there was so much history there with Rocky's grandfather and his father, Madison Square Garden and the WWE, that you just saw magic that night.
Now there's gonna be the man right there.
First third generation superstar ever. His father really made a name for himself here in Madison Square Garden. So did his grandfather, Rocky Maivia.
That night when I showed up at the Garden World, I was a bundle of nerves. That day was the greatest professional moment of my life. It was phenomenal that night, wrestling Kurt Angle in the Garden at the Royal Rumble. I will never, ever forget that.
I don't think I've ever heard anything like the reception that Triple H got at Madison Square Garden.
The game is back in business, and this sold-out crowd in Madison Square Garden just can't get enough of it.
I don't think I've ever seen anything like it, JR. I don't think I've ever heard anything like it.
This is an overwhelming show of respect. It is oozing from the hearts of every fan sitting here in Madison Square Garden.
I don't know of any place on earth that was more befitting of his return than Madison Square Garden. It's hallowed ground for Triple H's predecessors. It'll be hallowed ground after he's gone. So to come back on that turf, I think probably was the only place he should have come back.
It's a performer's dream to play Madison Square Garden.
Everything that you've ever heard was Madison Square Gardens in New York City. The first time I walked out onto the floor, and we were there like at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and you can feel the excitement in the air. Never could have gone there if I wouldn't have went to the WWE.
It's the only wrestling organization that ever wrestled in Madison Square Garden.
For three generations, McMahon's been promoting out of there, running shows. It's the pulse of WWE. It starts in New York City. It starts at Madison Square Garden.
Madison Square Garden is such a special place for wrestling. It's just the atmosphere. It's what, to me, professional wrestling is all about.
It's just a tradition. You know the people who walk through those curtains. You know the history of Madison Square Garden. Every great performer has been in Madison Square Garden.
You just know at some time, at some moment, another piece of history is going to happen in that building.
Up next, Brock brings the pain in the form of the F5.
The response I get from the crowd as I get my opponent over my shoulders, I believe in their mind that they know that the end is near, and I know that the end is near.